Dear traders, in this lecture I will continue with the walk forward analysis. It is known as well as walk forward optimization or walk forward validation, but the base word is walk forward, and I will show you what that means. Now, if I click on one of the strategies that I generated, you will see that we have here the walk forward. Before that, we have the optimizer, which works pretty similar to the optimizer in MetaTrader, but works much faster, and I will show it to you right now. So the optimizer finds better parameters for the strategy, and you can see on the balance chart we have the old balance line in gray color, and we can see how the parameters are changing. We have the range, the minimum and the maximum, and we have the step. Now, when we are optimizing a strategy, there is a risk to over-optimize the strategy. This means that the expert advisor studio might find better parameters for the indicators, but they will be exactly for this period of time. And if we run the strategy after that on MetaTrader, it might show losses. So this is why we either use round steps for optimization, like 5 or 10 or 20, or we use the other robustness tools like the walk forward validation, the Monte Carlo, and the multi-market. And now actually the optimizer works a little bit slower, because on the same computer that I'm recording, I have about 3 or 4 generators working simultaneously on my other screen. Simply, the Expert Advisor Studio, it works on a different tabs, which is very useful to mention. So you can just open it in another tab and run generator there, or if you want to run generator for a couple of currencies, you can do this simultaneously, but on different browsers, on different tabs, it works faster. Of course, if you make it too many, like 4, 5, 6, as I have done it in the moment, it might get a little bit slower. All right, so you see the optimizer is ready, and I can see the balance chart for the new strategy with the optimized parameters. And if I click on edit, I will be using it. So it's like I will accept the new parameters. All right, now I will not change the strategy. I will stick with the initial strategy that we had, and I will go to the walk forward. So here what we see are different segments. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Totally we have 5 segments. All right, and on the right side, you have the out of sample net profit. And you can see that the original outcome is in the first segment, it makes profit. In the second one, it loses. Then a small profit in the third one, the fourth one, the last one loses. Okay, now what is the idea of the walk forward? This is the whole backtested period that we have. And if we select to use 30% out of sample, what I have shown in the previous lectures, it will divide this whole period in different segments, and the first one will be 70%, and then this one will be 30%. So we can say the first segment is from this point over here, from the beginning till the end of this green line, or to the second vertical line. In the 70% of this period, it will optimize the strategy, and for the rest 30%, for this period of time, it will perform simulated trading. This is exactly what I have explained about the out of sample. So it's making out of sample, but not for the whole period, just for this zone over here, for the first segment. After that, it takes the parameters that are result from this optimization, and including this period where we had simulated trading, it performs new optimization. So you can see from here until here. All right, This is the optimization period for the second segment, and then it will simulate trading for the next zone, for this period, for the second green line. After that, same thing repeats. It will add this period and it will do optimization for this period over here, and it will simulate trading for the next segment. All right, and this repeats till the end. Now, what is the basic idea of having the walk forward validation? It is to recognize the over optimized strategy. So this strategy is the initial strategy that was generated, and we want to know if this strategy is over optimized for this period or not, if it is robust enough to use it in the future. Now, the walk forward analysis performs optimization for one period of time, then it simulates trading, then it includes the next period to the previous one, performs optimization and simulates trading for the next one, and this repeats till the end. Now, if the walk forward fails to find better parameters, this gives us a sign that the initial strategy might be over optimized, okay? Because it shows the result for the complete backtest, and if the walk forward fails to show better result, this means that the parameters of the initial strategy were over optimized. So let me run now the walk forward and you will see how it is working. It will start to optimize the strategy for the first segment, and then it will simulate trading for this zone over here between the first vertical and the second vertical line. And if I go to the parameters, you can see that I have here the original parameters, and now I can see the parameters of the first segment, and you can see that the RVI signal changed to 17. It's green because it is just 1 point higher than the initial value. And then the commodity channel index, or the CCI, changed the period and as well the level. So the period is bigger, that's why it's in green, and the level is smaller, that's why it is in red. And when it is ready with the first segment, it shows the second one, and it is optimizing it right now. Okay, going back to the equity chart, you can see here that the simulated trading shows worse results from the initial strategy. Okay, so the original is $103 of profit, and here we have just $11 of profit. And then you can see that for the second segment, it shows positive result of 9, and this is better because the initial strategy during this period has negative of 16. And this way we will see at the end if we will have a better strategy or not. Also, at the end, the walk forward analysis will show us what is the result of the complete backtest with the recent parameters, with the parameters from the last segment. Okay, this is something new with the walk forward in EA Studio. It was updated like last week. This is why I decided to include it in this course, because it's pretty interesting and useful for me. It's just another way to find better strategy, and you will see why. So now it is in the fourth segment, and you can see here only the period of CCI changed, 1 point lower than the previous one. So one more time to summarize it until it finishes, what it does, it optimizes one period and then simulates trading for the next one, then it includes this period to the previous and not to the whole previous period. You can see the whole period is divided by 5, and in each segment we have 70% for optimization and 30% to perform simulated trading. And let's have a look at the parameters. These are the parameters for the last period, and it's just completing the backtest. So now you can see that we have different values from the beginning. These are the original values that we have. The stop loss and the take profit were not changed because in settings I did not select to optimize the stop loss and the take profit. But you can see that the RVI signal was changed, the level was changed too, and then we have the CCI from 43 to 72 and from negative 197 to negative 219. So after it is ready, the walk forward performs complete backtest. And you can see that I have a better strategy than the original one. Even at the beginning and in the middle, it is going worse. So this one here is the new strategy after the walk forward optimization, and with the gray color is the original one. But you can see that just at the end, the new strategy makes more profit, okay? So we can say that this strategy is better, and actually here in the full backtest validation, it says, is strategy better? Yes, it is. And the validation is right over here. And as a validation, I just selected minimum net profit of $10. So if it is just profitable with a very small profit like $10, the strategy builder takes it as validated. And something very interesting here is that the complete backtest or the full backtest with the last parameters is as well with the out of sample, which means that it is validated with the acceptance criteria as well, which is 1.1 profit factor for the complete backtest and 1.1 for the in sample and for the out of sample. And this is very important because if we don't have that, then the strategy might be profiting at the beginning, then losing, or it could be the case that it will be losing in the out of sample part, which is just the recent historical data. But in this way, we filter the strategy in such a way so it shows us profit at the end of the test as well, or at the recent 30% of the test. Okay, let me now do the very same thing with the other strategy that I generated. It has much better equity line, so I'm very interested to see what will be the result there. Here are the parameters. So below we see the original equity line from the original strategy, and I will click on start and it will start to optimize the strategies again for each segment. It will perform simulated trading, then it will add this period, it will perform simulated trading again, and till the end. All right, I will pause the video now and I will continue once the test is ready. And here are the results. What we see is that we have worse strategy this time. Okay, the backtest with the final parameters show worse result than the initial strategy. Okay, so this is the difference. And I'm glad that I generated these two strategies so you will see the difference. And here you can see, is strategy better? No. Which means that the initial strategy made more profit, and the common acceptance criteria is not validated as well. If you remember, for the previous strategy as well, here was not valid, but is strategy better was yes, and it was green. So in order to say that the strategy passes the walk forward optimization, it needs to have three things. One is the strategy to be better, which is not true here. The common acceptance criteria to be validated, again, is not true with the strategy. And as well, to have all segments validated. And here we have all of them green, but they don't make profit of $10, because this is what we said is the validation, minimum net profit of 10. So this strategy did not pass the validation in any of the three criteria. And now to compare it with the equity chart of the different segments, we can see that the walk forward succeeded to make a better equity line. But this is the result of the walk forward when it's optimizing one segment, testing the strategy for the next one, then adding the data and testing it till the end. And we have a better strategy here. So this gives us a sign that the strategy is not over optimized. But in parameters, we see that with the last inputs of the indicators, the strategy actually made worse result than the original strategy. Okay? And if it was the other way around, if the new strategy with the last parameters passed the validation from the walk forward, I will see here green edit button. And the other tool to recognize the over optimized strategies is the Monte Carlo. So if I just click on the initial strategy, I can perform a Monte Carlo test, which I will explain in details in the next lecture. But if I click on start, you will see here that I have exactly 17 out of 20 tests validated, and this is for randomized indicator parameters and randomized backtest starting bar. Alright guys, I will continue now with the Monte Carlo, and if you have any questions about the walk forward, don't hesitate to write me. Thanks for watching. Cheers.